All right, it's 1978, a very good year. That's the year I started playing the drums. And but fortunately, before I started playing, I was a huge listener of music and a huge fan of all kinds of music. So the music was in me, and I loved funk, I loved soul, I loved big band. But this tune came out in 78 and just took the world by storm. It was a great dance anthem. The tune's called Got to Be Real. The artist was Cheryl Lynn, kind of a two or three hit wonder, but this is an anthem. You will hear this song all over the world. I've been all over the world, and I've heard this song at clubs, concerts, weddings, parties. You'll hear it in movies because it was one of those defining tunes in 1978, huge hit, just made people get up on the dance floor. And it featured James Gadson, another great R&B drummer we talked about earlier from the Use Me Groove by Bill Withers. Been on hundreds of great recordings. This is a simple groove in terms of what he's playing, but just profoundly funky. The tempo is great. It's got this unique tambourine part at the beginning, and the tambourine part has this totally swung jazz feel to it, and that's what's making you dance. So he's playing kind of an eighth note groove on the hi-hat, but the bass drum part he's playing is kind of what I call like a funk clave, because it's just, it's a funk anthem. Doom, 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 boom, 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 boom. And that bass drum pattern is just funk come to life. That kind of a pattern is on so many kinds of R&B grooves in that period. And then when he gets to the bridge, he does like kind of the disco on the hi-hat. And it's just a tune that even today, my kids are young. The minute I put that tune on, kids of any age, they just start, they just start dancing. There's no way you can hear that and not want to kind of tap something, move something, get the chicken neck going, whatever it is. It's just, it's a groove. And it's and then, you know, I became a DJ shortly after that. And that was one of those tunes that every time I would want to pack the dance floor, all I knew that I had to do was put on Got to Be Real. And it's got this great intro, really tight. Da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da, boom, da-da-da-da, ba-da, boom, tsk-gum-gum. And just those hits are so tight with the horn. The first one is with the floor tom. Da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da, boom, da-da-da-da, da-da. What I loved about this period of funk was and it started really with the Philadelphia soul stuff and really the Motown stuff, the beginning of really sophistication in R&B. Is with the James Brown stuff, it was more gritty, more earthy, more, it didn't have as much in the way in the early days of like crazy arrangements. And then as the Philadelphia soul came and the Motown came more the rich, lush orchestrations of beautiful string parts, horn parts, and by 78, you had all of that stuff still, but the recordings sounded completely different, and the drums were now very fat, funk 70s, is a different sound, very produced sounding, but that wasn't a bad thing. It was produced, just sonically things were different. If they recorded the same music 10 years earlier with the same players, just sonically the record would have sounded different because the technology changed, and soundboards and engineering techniques. So this has this, that fat in your face, the drums are right there, you feel like the guy played in your bedroom. It's a sound that no longer exists because drum sounds have completely changed, but there's something really great and beautiful about those funk recordings of the 70s, the Earth, Wind & Fire stuff, the Casey and the Sunshine Band stuff, the Bee Gees, all that R&B stuff, that funk of that period. They just had this fat, tight kick drum sounds, and the drums are right there in your living room, but, and you're feeling every little nuance they're playing. But this is a funk anthem. But check out, you know, again, how he plays parts. He's not just playing busy all over the place. And some of the cats from Toto were on the recording session. Toto was a fairly large, legendary band in the 70s and 80s that featured Jeff Porcaro. A bunch of studio guys in L.A. started their own band and became Toto. But this featured like David Paich on keyboards and just some of the great L.A. studio musicians of the period. Got to be real. Got to get it going on. Got to get the record. Got to get your head moving. Got to start dancing. Got to do something. But you got to make it funky.